If you can remember where you stashed your passport...
Bloody expired.
It might be time to dust it off.
And I know the prospect of flying overseas might feel a long way off, especially with New South Wales and Victoria in lockdown. Some people might even say that we are being too optimistic.
But a little optimism is what many of us need. And Qantas is confident we'll reach vaccination targets of 80% by the end of the year.
The idea of planning a trip might encourage even more people to get the jab.
If that's the case, from mid-December, we could be jetting off to Fiji, Singapore or Japan. While for those dreaming of a white Christmas, the UK, the US and Canada are also on the list. In 2022, even more destinations are on the itinerary. Hong Kong from February, and then by April, you can take your pick of tropical hotspots. Bali, Jakarta, Manila, Thailand and Vietnam on the agenda, so is Johannesburg. And Qantas will need those planes to be full. The Flying Kangaroo limped through its first full year of COVID-19, announcing an underlying loss before tax of just under $2 billion. There are some who think this is all a flight of fancy.
And every time there's no reopening on these artificial self-proclaimed timetables from Qantas, when it doesn't eventuate, they go cap in hand to the federal government.
Getting on a plane out of here, that's the easy part. Returning to Fortress Australia is where things get a little bit tricky. And Alan Joyce flagged that if mandatory hotel quarantine is still the solution, it's going to be very hard to convince Australians to travel overseas and even harder to convince tourists to come here.
And the gateway down under could soon be the top end. Qantas considering canning the direct Perth to London leg due to WA's severe border policies.
And I think it would be a terrible shame if that when we got to Christmas in New South Wales, you could visit your relatives in London but can't visit your relatives in Perth.
We put in place $15 million worth of improvement at the terminal. They need to... Show some understanding and perhaps some gratitude.
There has to come a point in time where leaders say, OK, enough's enough. We now have to accept we can't live like this forever. We have to allow loved ones to come together. We have to allow Australians to move freely within Australia.
That would truly be the spirit of Australia. Charlotte Goodlett for 10 News First.